had an arched roof, it had a keystone. There must be something wrong with that mortar.
Waiting for James to mend his bodywork again meant my bodywork started to go off.
Oh.
But eventually, he was ready.
It's really rather pleasant. It's just like being at home with the windows open.
Richard, meanwhile, had added some floral go-faster stripes, and I'd opened up my cow's rectum to improve the ventilation.
We have had a few problems. We've only covered, yes, 2 miles in 2 days, but here we are, as a threesome, going along.
But then...
It's a river and not a small one. Your brakes are falling off,
your
mate.
Your bonnet's falling off.
It's all right. There's redundancy built into it.
Is there?
Yeah.
Since Richard is the team bumpkin, we decided he should go first.
OK, all my community of people, make for higher ground. Just climb.
Hammond's Ark made it to the other side safely.
Yeah!
And then it was my go.
I'm really deep here. Really, really deep. Oh no! Cows leak. That's a terrible thing to learn.
However, I too made it with relative ease.
Eat my meat, Hammond!
But then...
Look at this. Tragic.
An old man driving a low garden wall into a river. Now let's look on the bright side. If this doesn't work as a car, it will be very effective as a dam.
He's not doing it quite as quickly as you or I did.
Nor as aggressively, nor as purposefully. His car is also riding a lot lower than ours because it weighs so much.
Yeah.
That's getting very deep. It may be leaking slightly. It's leaking a lot. Cack. Chaps, I think I'm beached.
Being honest, there's not a great deal we can do about it. You're in the river, we're here.
Right, if I go right a bit, I should... clear that. Oh, yes.
Oh, the
slide's just...
Yeah, that's... So the mortar's dissolving and the bricks are just falling off.
Yes.
That's more gone.
Oh, God! The mortar's dissolving!
He's just transporting his own cameras along. That's all he's doing.
Spindly arms throwing a brick.
Help!
We're going to have to put him out of his misery.
No, look, we're just abandoning him.
Do you think?
What is the point of it?
James, can you hear me? We've analysed the situation and there is
literally nothing we can do to help. Nothing.
Leaving James in his dissolving car, we headed off to make camp and get supper underway.
Well, apart from your rather tragic tents, this isn't so bad.
It's all right. Yeah, it is amazing. My car, the way it disappears into that hedge, it's not just camouflage, it is hedge.
I would agree, yours is remarkable.
Meanwhile, James's car had shed so much weight that he was able to get free and start raping the countryside again to rebuild it.
Bastards. Bastards.
You know, what's incredible about this sustainable living is our barbecue is made from bricks from James's car. The kindling and the vegetables are from your car.
Are you about to tell me I'm eating...
bat wing?
You buy a steak, it says keep refrigerated.
It's been
stick to the side of your car, leave it in the sun, then drive it to a river.
Ooh.
is making such a racket, isn't it?
It's worse than last time. The difference on this trip, well, he's been tearing nature apart.
Oh, I know.
I've never felt closer to him. Well, he's just messing it up, otherwise.
Holy cow. Hammond.
What? What are you doing?
You couldn't see it. There's a hedge trimmer.
That's
trimmer.
My community, you rural bastard!
Oh.
The next morning, to cheer up Hammond following the decimation of his car and his woodland animal community, I made breakfast.
Eat it.
No.
Why not?
Because it's going green.
It's just a bit of door.
See where the flies have been on it? It's disgusting. Hello? Hello? What? It's a dung heap.
It is a dung heap.
Morning.
Morning. What are you, is this a car? What is it?
It is a totally sustainable car made of effectively wattle and daub. Only the wattle has been replaced by straw and the daub has been replaced by cow poo. But the principle's the same.
How the hell do you fit in it?
Well, only just.
And where's your windscreen?
There.
Hang on.
Can we just test your blind spots, James? Can you see either of us now?
No.
Heavily pedestrianised areas should be avoided.
Right, come on, we've just got 2 miles to go.
Yes.
Jesus Christ. The
Oh!
What's this, that?
It breaks my heart, but it's a small gift for you.
Is it?
Yes, from me and my woodland community.
Oh, it's a dead bat.
Yeah.
Bats have sonar, don't they?
Yeah.
So I could use it as a reversing parking sensor.
Yeah, I don't think it works once the bat is dead.
And so, with all of us running...
My reversing bat is working well.
We began the final 2 mile leg of our epic journey.
Oh, Paul!
There are some issues associated with environmentalism, and we're seeing one of them right now.
Am I anywhere near the gate?
James attempted to tie his car back together using a ball of string, which went well.
Why did they make it in a ball shape? What a stupid idea.
But eventually it was done and we were on our way.
James, how much does it weigh now?
I'm going to say the weight has gone down a bit. I think I'm down to 3 tons.
So you still need an HGV license?
But it's not a type of car known to the DVLA.
Mind you, I had even bigger problems. My car was starting to smell really bad.
One of the sound recorders just came to fiddle with my microphone and actually was sick.
Eventually, though, our destination hoved into view.
After 3 days grueling travel over 11 miles, we're here. This must be it.
It was the inaugural Sustainable Living Motorsport Challenge on a track carved out of nature itself.
Oh, hang on. Text message.
What?
I've got a text here from Mr. Wilman with the instructions of what we're doing. Whoever does the most laps in 1 hour wins.
Well, James, that's not going to be you.
Oh, you don't know.
No, I do know. It's not going to be you.
Oh, no, wait, hang on. You will be racing against 3 old-fashioned steel cars.
Oh,
hello.
Yes, those.
Oh, there they are.
How quaint.
No, they don't look quaint. They look ridiculous.
It's funny, that's the nature of progress, isn't it? Suddenly they look stupid.
They do.
The museum pieces were being driven by 3 local yobbos.
Right, this is it. The Meteor, the Treaty, and the PTI are ready.
gone. I couldn't see the flag. Yes, there are some hay bales. I'll follow those. Where the hell does it go next?
Despite the excellent start from Richard and I, we were quickly overwhelmed by the steel cars.
And now the golf got past!
Richard and I really needed was help from our colleague. Sadly, though...
Not going to take a racing lot. I'm completely lost. Trouble is, the racetrack looks the same as the front of the car. What a stupid idea for an event.
I've lost the other nose tampon. Help! I may have to pick for another tampon.
Where am I going?
Hi, James.
No time to lose! But for these super absorbent, slightly larger nose tampons, which I hope will last a little longer.
Given that we were in an endurance race, our tactics so far had been to protect our cars. But with the cars of the past racking up so many laps, we had to get the hammer down.
The mighty diesel against them. Whatever that is, 1.6 litre. Golf. Yes. Yes. I've got him.
Power sliding ahead.
I've done a lap.
With us three, well, two, making good progress, the cars from the past started to play dirty.
That is out of order. They're getting violent.
Oh! Oh, no! I've lost the tampon again.
Who was that?
Mess with us just because we like trees, dear. That's out of order, mate. You can't. Have that.
The bone is taking on the steel.
Although we were holding our own, the relentless pressure started to take its toll on our vehicles.
Ah. I've lost part of the hands.
Smell. What kind of smell? Is that from the exhaust?
With Hammond distracted by the hot exhaust burning his bodywork, it was all down to my cow car.
Good dicing here between the past and the future. It's neck and neck. Oh.
But then.
Oh no no! Disaster!
Oh hell, looks like Jeremy's got trouble.
How do you peel a cow?
Having eventually got to the overheating engine and seen it had become a production line for maggots, I decided to go off and be sick.
News from the inaugural sustainable motorsport event on a sustainable track or whatever it's called. Jeremy Clarkson has retired with a maggot infestation.
This meant all our hopes rested with Richard Hammond and his smouldering arc.
Yeah, you're right, boy.
But then...
Oh, my God! Oh, no!
Oh, no, more news from the Sustainable Motorsport Challenge is that... Ow! Richard Hammond, I believe, is on fire. The garden centre is ablaze.
Oh, God. Oh, no. Oh, no! That's going to make it worse.
Oh. With Hammond's car on fire, mine alive, and James is disintegrating again,
ow, ow.
We decided that environmentalism simply doesn't work.
with that, back to the tent.
Holy crap!
So there we are. There we are. We've looked into it. We've looked into it thoroughly, and I'm afraid we're all doomed. We're all going to die. And on that terrible disappointment, I'm afraid it's time to end. See you next week. Goodbye.